Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ahla wa sahlan. My name is Yaqut Zaman. Hope you guys are having a wonderful time. We are going through Mukhtasar al-Quduri. This is my channel, Roots of Knowledge. I go through various types of videos so you guys can benefit as much as possible. So, without any delay, let's crack on with the series then. So, this is to do with Zakat of Ghanam. So, he says, what is Ghanam? How much Zakat do you give if you have 789 goats, meaning 789 goats? What is ma'az? Is zakat given on all male horses? What is the difference between Abu Hanifa and Sahibin on horses? How do you calculate zakat on horses? And when is zakat given on donkeys? These are the questions for you guys to think about. Right, so here he says, let's just write the words first. So ghanam means sheep or goats. Right, so goats and sheep is like a generic word that's used for both. So the zakat of if a person has goats or sheep. So 40, you guys should know that, 40. And then you got sa'ima, you guys should know that as well. And then you got zadat, means to increase. Zada yazidu, ziyada. And you got shatan, mi'atain, it means 200. Shiyah is a jama, the plural of shat. Right, so balagat 400. And then you got dha'an, which is like sheep. And then ma'az, which is like goats. Right, so you guys know the difference. You can Google it. You can find the difference between the two. Okay, so zakat, khayl, horses. Khayl is horses. And dhukur is the jama of dhakar, which means male. And inath is the jama of untha, which is female. Okay, sahibuha bil khiyar, it means choice. A'ta, faras is another word for horse. Dinar is a gold coin. Gold coin. Qawwama yuqawwim wa taqweem, to valuate something, to give something a particular value. Khamsu, mi'a, or khamsa rather, munfarida, on its own, in front of the word farad, on its own, alone. And then you've got bighal, which is a jama of baghal, which means a mule, and hamir is basically donkey, right? And tijara is trade, business. Okay, so aqal, laysa fi aqalla, is ghair munsarif, so it's the majroor of fi. Shatun, shatan, arbain shatan, yes, shatan. Sadaqatun is the ism of laysa, and then sa'imatan is going to be the khabar of kanat. Hala alayha al-hawlu, hala is fi'l. Hawl is the fa'il, and then you got shat is the mubtada. You've got mi'at mi'atin majurur, zadat is the fi'il. Now you can say wahidatan, right, which then would say zadat is talking about the goats, and then wahidatan would mean that the tamiz, or it could mean the increased one, but I'm going to make it the fa'il. Yeah, one increased. Right, so I just change the file from the file. Zadat wahidatun fiha thalathu shiyahin is the mubtada. Fiha is the khabar. And then you got balagat arba'mi'a fiha arba'u shiyahin. Arba'u is again mubtada. Kulli mi'atin shatun. Yeah. And then ad-da'nu wal-ma'zu sawa. Da'an al-ma'z mubtada and sawa is the khabar. Okay, babu zakat al-khayli. Hada babu zakat al-khayli. Iza kanat al-khaylu. Khayl is the ism of kanat. Sa'imatan is the khabar. Dhukuran wa inathan. That's going to be another khabar or sifa. Sahibuha mubtada. Now the khabar is actually here. Okay, actually, this, my text is a bit messed up. So it's actually bil khiyar is the khabar. And then hala alayha al-hawlu is the... So it's supposed to be sahibuha bil khiyari. Oh, sorry, وَحَالَ عَلَيْهَا الْحَوْلِ فَصَاحِبُهَا بِالْخِيَارِ. That's how it's supposed to be. Probably in your books. إِنْ شَاءَ أَعْطَى and كُلِّ فَرَسٍ دِينَارًا is the مَفْعُول بِهِ of أَعْطَى. And then قَوَّمَ يُقَوِّمُ تَقْوِيمُ فِي الْفَائِلِ أَعْطَى and كُلِّ مِئَتَي دِرْهَمٍ خَمْسَةً. Okay, this is خَمْسَةً or خَمْسَةَ دَرَاهِمَ. Now, why is it دَرَاهِمَ? Why is it single fatha? Alright, let me know in the comments if you know the answer to this. في ذكورها منفردة. This would become the the hal or the the hal. So zakatun is the ism of laysa. Laysa zakatun fi dhukuriha. Inda Abi Hanifata wa Abi Yusufa Muhammadun la zakata la nafi al jins single fatha al khayl ولا شيء من البغال في البغال حمير إلا أن تكون سلسان للتجارة. Okay, so let's look at the masail now. So the masail basically straightforward. If you have up to 40 goats, there is no zakat. Meaning you don't have 40, you have 39 or less. There is no zakat. But if you have 40 or more, then your zakat starts. Right, so your zakat starts at 40. That's the nisab. So you have 40 all the way up to 100, meaning up to 99. You have to give one goat as your zakat. Then after 120. Then after 120 all the way up to 200, you have to give another goat. So there's two now. And then from 200 all the way up to 300, you have to give three goats. And then 300 to 400, four goats. And so forth. So then it works in 100s basically. Every time you hit 100, you got to give an extra goat. And that's it basically. That's the calculation for goats. It's probably the easiest out there. Right? So every 100 after that, you have to give one goat. So if I said, if you have 670, how many goats do you have to give? So 600, so 6 basically. If you had 1,500, how much do you have to give? So you got 1,500. So that's 15, you got to give 15 goats, and so forth. So laysa, there is not in aqalla, in less than 40 goats, sadaqa zakat. فَإِذَا كَانَتْ, so when it is 40 sa'imatan, self-grazing, وَحَالَ عَلَيْهَا الْحَوْلُ, and 1 year has passed over it, فَفِيهَا, then in it is a shat, a goat, إِلَى مِئَةٍ وَإِشْرِينَ, up to 120. فَإِذَا زَادَتْ, so once it increases, one increases, فَفِيهَا shatan, so if it goes beyond 120, you got to give 2. إِلَى مِئَتَيْنَ, and this number works all the way up to 20, not including 20. فَإِذَا زَادَتْ, and once it goes beyond that, وَاحِدَةٌ فَفِيهَا ثَلَاثٌ, then you have to give 3 shia. فَإِذَا بَلَغَتْ أَرْبَعُمِئَةٌ فَفِيهَا, once it reaches 400, then you got to give 4. ثُمَّ فِي كُلِّ مِئَةٍ, in every 100, شَاتٌ, there's a goat you have to give. Okay, finished. Last. وَالْضَعْنُ وَالْمَعْزُ سَوَى. So the da'an and the ma'z are equal. So it basically means 100, at every 100 interval, you have to give an extra one. Alright, so da'anu and ma'zu is considered to be the same. Yeah, meaning that kind of woolly goat, sheep, we call, and the normal kind of hair one, they're equal, meaning whether you have them, whether you have sheep, the numbers are equal, right? The zakat is equal regarding both. Okay, next. This is the chapter of Babu Zakat al-Khayl. Okay, Zakat al-Khayl. This is to do with horses now. So there is an ikhtilaf with regards to, do you have to give zakat on horses or not? So let's divide horses into three categories. Only female horses. Let's say a person has only female horses. Or a person has only male horses. Male and female horses. Or a person has only male horses. Everyone agrees, if you have only male horses, let's say you had 1,000 male horses, there's no zakat on them. Because the idea of zakat is based upon productivity, the potential of increase. And because horses themselves are not going to increase, male horses, they need females to increase. That's why there's no zakat on them. However, the ikhtilaf is about if you have female or male and female horses, then what? So if you have male and female, obviously they're going to mate. They're going to increase, the numbers. And if you have female, then you can introduce a male to mate with them. You know, they usually used to borrow a male horse from someone and let it ride around with the female horses and then they'd mate. So this would give you productivity, right? An increase. So Abu Hanifa rahimahullah's position on this is, yes, you have to give zakat on these types of horses. And Imam Muhammad and Abu Yusuf, they say no zakat on any type of horse at all. So the difference basically is in that, whether there's zakat on horses or not. Alright, so when it comes to this issue, Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, he calculates the zakat in two ways of horses. So let's say there's a horse. There's one way you can calculate the zakat of a horse is, for every horse that you have, you basically give one gold coin. Right, so for every one horse, you give one gold coin, right? So one gold coin per horse. Or the other way is you can value each horse, find out its value, and then you give basically for every, you know, whatever its value is. So for every 200, you give 5 silver coins. Or basically, you just work out 2.5% of the value. So for example, like let's say there's a horse that is 200, worth 200. You give 5 silver coins. And let's say it's worth 400. You're going to give 10 silver coins. And let's say if it's worth 600, you're going to give 15 silver coins. Oh, by the way, this is one dirham, okay? Dinar. I wrote dirham. Gold coin is a dinar, right? Just to clarify that. So if you've got 400, 200, once 5 silver coins, 400, you give 10, you got 600, you're going to give 15, and so forth. Now, the easier way is just take whatever number, and then you work out 2.5% of that. And that's basically how it works. All right, so that's Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah's position on this. So, إذا كانت, when the khayl, the horses, are sa'imatan, self-grazing, remember, ذكوراً and إناث, male and female, فصاحبها, then the owner is بالخيار, has a choice of how to give the zakat. وحال عليه الحول, remember, 1 year has to pass. إن شاء, if he wills, أعطى, he gives, and كل فرس, on behalf of every horse, 1 dinar, gold coin. وإن شاء, and if he wills, he qawwamaha, he can, instead of giving this, he can valuate it. وَأَعْطَى, and gives, and كُلِّ مِئَتَي dirhamin, for every 200 it comes up to, 5 silver coins. Right? Like I just explained it over there. وَلَيْسَ فِي ذُكُورِهَا, and there is not in the male on its own. مُنْفَرِدَةً زَكَاتٌ. In other words, if a person had millions of male horses, no zakat then. According to Abu Hanifa. Abu Yusuf and Muhammad rahimahullah regarding the zakat of horses, they say there is no zakat on horses. Yeah, so la zakat fil khayli at all. Finish, end the story. Right, so you don't need to work out anything. Anyway, is there any zakat when it comes to mules? Because a mule is a cross between a horse and between a donkey. So there's no zakat on donkeys, right, at all. And because mules are made from a male donkey and a female horse, the ruling follows the male. Right, so if you Google it, actually see if you can find a mule that's born from a female donkey and a male horse. See if you can find it. If you can, I'll be surprised. But generally, horses can only be mules can only be from male donkeys that mate with female horses. Okay, so wala fi shay'in. I think the Arabic is a bit wrong there. وَلَا فِي شَيْءٍ مِنْ الْبِغَالِ وَلَا شَيْءَ فِي الْبِغَالِ is supposed to be. وَلَا فِي شَيْءٍ, and there's no zakat in anything of بِغَال or حَمِير, mules, donkeys, إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ لِلْتِجَارَةِ, unless they are for تجارة, right? Unless they are for business. I think my other computer just came on there. You guys just heard that sound. So unless the horse, donkeys are for business. So let's say, for example, like someone has a trade, a business. And this business is basically that they buy and sell donkeys. If you have a business that buys and sells anything, we're going to talk about that later on in this book. But if you have a business that buys and sells anything, you have to give zakat on the inventory. So donkeys are inventory in this business. So they have to give zakat on them. And we're going to talk about at what value do you have to give zakat on them. Right? So you have to give zakat on the value of the donkeys. And for that matter, anything you have in a business that you're buying and selling, you got to give zakat on those things. And there you go. That's it. So I hope that makes sense. All we learned today is about the goats and sheep. And we learned about horses today. And let's answer those questions then that you had early on. So what is ghanam? How much zakat do you give if you have 789 goats? What is ma'az? Is zakat given on all male horses? Meaning on all male horses, male alone horses. What is the difference between Abu Hanif and Sahibain on horses? How do you calculate zakat on horses? And when is zakat given on donkeys? You guys should not be able to answer that now. If you can't, play back, watch it again. And Jazakum Allah Khair, leave a comment as well if you enjoyed the series, if it's beneficial for you guys. And if you're teaching this book and you're using these videos as well, please leave a comment as well. Jazakum Allah Khair. Thank you very much. I will see you guys next time. Thank you to my patrons for all the support you guys are showing. Patrons are basically those of you guys who financially support my channel on a monthly basis. I really appreciate any donations, any support that you guys show to my channel, because all the content I make is for everyone to watch free of charge. So in order for me to be able to make it free of charge for people to watch, then this is the best way. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you very much. And I will see you guys next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.